Arduino few days back launched the successor of Arduino Uno R3 board, that is Arduino Uno R4, and it has two variants. One is Arduino Uno R4 Minima and the second one is Arduino Uno R4 Wi-Fi. This Arduino Uno R4 Wi-Fi has a ESP32 chipset inbuilt, so we expect Wi-Fi and Bluetooth connectivity. And with Wi-Fi connectivity, we got the support of Arduino IoT Cloud as well. And this new Arduino Uno R4 board has the same form factor as the Arduino Uno R3 board, and the pinout is exactly same as R3 board. Having the same form factor and pinout, now we can easily use all the shield or module of Arduino Uno R3 board with this new R4 board. Last year, I designed a learning PCB for beginners, which is a kind of Arduino Uno R3 shield. Just put the shield on the Arduino Uno R3 board and easily make cool home automation projects. It's a kind of plug and play thing. If we want Bluetooth connectivity with Arduino Uno R3, we need external Bluetooth module. Now this Arduino Uno R4 board has ESP32 chipset inbuilt, so no need of any external Bluetooth or Wi-Fi module here. Using this shield with the Arduino Uno R4 Wi-Fi board, now we can easily make lots of IoT projects as well. Before getting into this video, I want to let you know about Ultium. Ultium is a leading provider of innovative PCB design software and tools that are transforming the electronics industry. Ultium has some amazing features like advanced interactive routing with auto completion, any angle routing, bus routing, phase and length tuning, follow me routing and lot more, which make it an ideal choice for PCB designing tool by a lot of companies. Along with this, they do also have Ultium 365. With the addition of Ultium 365, this leading PCB design software in the world moves into a whole new dimension, creating seamless collaboration across the entire PCB design process. Ultium 365 allows us to share our PCB design online via web, sharing designs to mechanical team for product design, centralized cloud storage and lot more. And along with all this, they have a very useful platform called Octopart, kind of a search engine for electronic components. Using Octopart, now we can search for any components and we will able to compare its price and availability around the globe. And not only that, we can also get the details about the components like its specification and the datasheet all at one single place. Ultium connects PCB designers, part suppliers and manufacturers to develop and manufacture electronic products faster and more efficiently. If you are interested in trying out Ultium Designer, they are currently offering a limited time promotion where you can get Ultium Designer for free for 30 days. All the links are available in the description. In this video, I will show you how can we make a home automation project using this Arduino Uno R4 Wi-Fi board and Arduino IoT Cloud. And with this project, we will able to control two relays using a smartphone app, from web dashboard, from IR remote and from the Alexa smart speaker. This is going to be a very interesting home automation project. This is the schematic of PCB. If you want your own custom designed PCB, then you can download this schematic from the link given in the video description. After making the schematic, convert it into PCB. Arrange and place all the components in desirable places. Once the layout is ready, route the wiring and complete the design of PCB. After the completion of PCB design, you need to download 3 files, which will require during PCB order. These files are BOM, Gerber and CPL, that is pick and place file. Now open JLC PCB website and click on quote now button under PCB assembly. Click here to upload the Gerber file of your PCB. Here JLC PCB will automatically set all the parameters of PCB. Now select the PCB quantity and color masking of PCB by yourself. Scroll down below and select for PCB assembly. Here you have to select on which surface you want to be PCB assembly, either on the top side or bottom side. In my case, it is top side. After that, click on confirm button. For PCB assembly, we need two more files. One is BOM, that is bill of material, and the second one is CPL, that is pick and place file. Upload these two files one by one. Here you need to give the description about your PCB, for which purpose you want to make this PCB. I am giving here Arduino Home Automation Shield. All the components were shown here that are to be assembled. In case if you want to not assemble any particular component, then you can deselect that component. After checking all the components, click on next button.
Here you will see all the component that has to be assembled by JLC PCB along with pricing. Now click on save to cart to complete your order. After 7 days, PCBs arrived at my place in a very good packaging. Packaging quality of JLC PCB is pretty good. Damaging of PCB during shipping is almost impossible. As usual, the quality of PCB is very premium and look pretty professional. Traces are perfect, soldier mask is too good, and the SMT components are soldered very well. Overall, PCB along with assembly is great and it is pretty affordable.
Search Arduino IoT Cloud on Google. Here click on Arduino Cloud. Here you need to create your account for Arduino Cloud. If you already have account, just sign in using your login credentials. Now click on this dotted icon on the right top corner and then click on IoT Cloud. Here first we need to create thing. Now click on this create thing button. Give any name of this thing. I am giving it my Arduino Uno R4. Then click on add variable. Here you need to give the name of this variable. I am giving it light1. Then select the variable type as Alexa compatible because we want to control our devices using Alexa as well. Now click on light and leave this setting as it is. Now click on add variable button below to complete the configuration of this variable. In similar way, create another variable as we want to control two relays. This is a two node home automation project. Here both the variables are created successfully. Now click here on this icon to associate the Arduino Uno R4 board. Click on setup new device. Here we have to select which device we want to set up, third party device or Arduino board. Arduino Uno R4 is a Arduino board, so select Arduino board. Here we need a tool called Arduino Create Agent. This tool will help to communicate Arduino IoT Cloud with Arduino board. If you already have it, then proceed further or else download from here and install in your computer. After installation, open this Arduino Create Agent. Now computer is able to communicate with Arduino R4 board. After installing the Arduino Create Agent, it will automatically detect the board if it is connected to your computer. As you can see, it found my Arduino Uno R4 board. Now click on Configure button. Give the name of your device. I am giving it TechnoLab. Here a device ID and a secret key is generated and this key and ID is very important. This can't be recovered once it is lost, so keep it safe. Just download the PDF file and keep it safe. We need this secret key later. Now click on continue after checking the box. To use Arduino IoT Cloud with Arduino Uno R4, we need to install a firmware into this Arduino Uno R4 board. Arduino Create Agent will check if your board has firmware installed or not. If not, it will automatically install into your board. Now we need to unplug the Arduino board, then plug in again. Now click on this confirm button. Here our Arduino Uno R4 board has been successfully set up. Now click on this configure button. Here we need to give the name of our Wi-Fi, that is SSID, and the password as well. And the secret ID that we generated earlier. Open that PDF and copy the secret ID and paste it here. Click on save button. Now go to dashboard, then click on build dashboard. Give the name of your dashboard. I am giving it Arduino Home Automation. Here click on add button. here click on things, this one that we created earlier. Click on this, then click on create widgets. Here two buttons added automatically as we want to control two relays. Now again click on things, open this thing and then click on sketch. Here a basic template of code for our project is created. Now click here, open full editor. We can edit this code or even we can upload this code from here only. This is an online IDE, but I am not going to use it, rather I will use Arduino IDE. To download this code, click on this three dot icon button, then click on download sketch. This is the final code of our project. I have modified the code and added IR remote control part as well. Here our both the relays are connected at pin number 7 and pin number 8 respectively. And IR sensor is connected at pin number 11. Here you need to add the hexadecimal value of your IR remote. And the code for retrieving hexadecimal code is available in the description. You can download and retrieve the code and mention here. And then the code is pretty simple. You can easily understand this code. Just go through it. I will put this code in the description. One more thing, this code is not going to work for your Arduino board because this code is generated for my Arduino board device ID only. Well, you can use this code as a reference. Now I am going to upload this code. First select the right board and right COM port and then hit upload button. To control the appliances from the smartphone, we need to download this Arduino IoT remote app. And this app is available for both iOS as well as for Android. Download this app and then open. Now login with the same account that you were created on the Arduino IoT cloud web page. And here it will automatically detect the dashboard that we created earlier on the Arduino IoT cloud page. As you can see, both the button widgets are available here. Now we can easily control the relays from this app as well. Now let's integrate Alexa. For this, open Alexa app, then click on more in the bottom right corner. After that, tap on skills and game. Here search for Arduino IoT cloud. Tap on this one. Tap on this button which says enable to use. Here my Arduino account is successfully linked with the Alexa. Here as you can see, light 1 and light 2 devices is showing here. Now we are able to control the relays from this Alexa app too, along with the Alexa speaker. Now connect the bulb or whatever device you want to control as per this circuit diagram. Now everything is done, let's see project in action. Alexa, turn off light 1.
Okay.
Alexa, turn on light 2.
Okay.
Alexa, turn on light 1.
Okay.
That's all for this video. I hope you have enjoyed this video and learned something new. Please do subscribe my YouTube channel and hit like button for such informative videos. Thank you so much for watching this video. Bye bye. Take care.